Hey everybody, Elena here from PC World. I've got another case teardown video for you all. This time we're looking at Corsair's new 5000 series. This lineup is a riff essentially on their 4000 series, which came out last September, but they've basically taken the 4000 series lineup, made it bigger, added some premium touches. So we'll dive into all of those details in just a second. First, I want to remind you all, as always, that this is not a review, so no thermal, no acoustic information. I'm going to be really focusing on the teardown, tour, comparison with the 4000 series, and all of that hopefully will combine to give you a solid idea of what it's like to build in these cases. So let's get started. All right, so specs for the 5000 series. For all three models, you're really looking at the same basic case. Just like the 4000 series, Corsair is using the same basic chassis and then, you know, swapping out panels, including different fans and number of fans, and then also including a RGB controller or not to differentiate the models. Otherwise, basically the same for colors, dimensions. So, speaking of colors, there's two options available, black and white. Here we have the black 5000D Airflow model. That's what you're looking at right now. And then for how much space it takes, in US measurements, it is about 20.5 inches, both depth and height. And then for width, it's about 9.5 inches. In millimeters, that's 520 mils for depth and height, and then 240 millimeters for the width. Motherboard sizes accommodated are EATX, ATX, MicroATX, and MiniATX. All right, so for fan sizes accommodated, you can do up to three 120 millimeter fans at the front, or two 140 millimeter fans. The top can do up to two 120 or two 140 millimeter fans. The back can do a single 120 millimeter fan. And then specific to the 5000 series, there is a motherboard tray included that can do up to three 120 millimeter fans. All right, so for radiator sizes accommodated, you're looking at up to 360 or 280 millimeter rads at the front, up to 280 millimeter rads at the top, 120 millimeter rads at the back, and then for the motherboard tray that I mentioned, that again we'll show you in closer detail later on, that can do up to a 240 millimeter rad, but if you populate that, you can't really populate the front, and again, we'll go over that in more detail later on as well. For component clearances, you're looking at up to 420 millimeters of clearance for GPUs, up to 170 millimeters for CPU coolers, and then for power supplies, you get up to 225 millimeters of room. And then for drives, you can do up to two 3.5 inch drives or up to four 2.5 inch drives. This case also includes four dust filters, so you'll find them at the front, the top, the bottom, and then also there is one on the solid side panel where there's a cutout. And then finally, as you can see right here, you can do vertical GPU mounting in this case, and it accommodates up to two slot cards. Okay, moving on to some highlights on the exterior of these cases. First up is the front I/O ports. Again, because the 5000 series cases share the same chassis, this is going to be the same across all the different models. You're going to get a power button, two USB 3.0 Type A ports, a single USB 3.1 Type C port, combination headphone and microphone jack, and then a reset button. Before we move on to showing the interior of the case, I just wanted to show a quick side-by-side comparison of two of the models. So on the left here, you have the 5000D Airflow, and this is the model that you've seen for most of the videos so far. And then here on the right, we have the 5000X, And this is the slightly upgraded version. Not pictured here is the 5000D, the standard model, and that's just all solid panels. Now, it might look like a trick of the light here, but these actually are pretty much the same case. They are the same height, same chassis, same everything. The only difference is really between these three models, as I've mentioned before, is that the panels are a bit different. So here with the Airflow model, you have these cutout panels on the top and the front, and these form basically a mesh case. And then here on the 5000X, you're getting all tempered glass, and actually you're getting it on all four sides. So it's tempered glass, tempered glass, tempered glass, and even tempered glass on this side as well. However, this side is not actually as bad as you might assume in terms of having to do great cable management. I'll show that to you in just a second, but it's pretty simple. And in fact, you can probably do some really interesting customizations with it as well. I do want to note as well, with this tempered glass, I know some people will kind of worry about airflow. You do get about a half inch of clearance between where the panel ends on this side and where the mesh filter is. And then there are these cutouts here, these channels for air on the side. So unlike a full glass panel here at the front, you are getting better airflow than you might assume. The tempered glass is a smidge thicker than this steel panel, and I'll just pull this off real quick to show you both how it mounts, which is with these resistance pegs. It comes off real easy with just a light tug, and also to show you a side-by-side of the thicknesses. So this is the metal panel. It's a little bit thinner. And so, I mean, maybe you're getting like, I don't know, another eighth of an inch at most of clearance for the side channels for airflow. Obviously, because this one's a mesh style panel, you're going to get more airflow in general just because, you know, it's not solid. But you hold it side by side with the glass, you can kind of get a sense of how thick each one is. The fun thing about this, because it's all interchangeable, is that if you really wanted to, you could actually take a mesh panel. I mean, this one's black, but if you got it in white, you could just put it on this white 5000X. Now you have a little more airflow. And here's that look at the side panel for the 5000X that I promised. As you can see, what is normally a solid side panel is actually made of tempered glass, one part see-through, and then one part here that's for airflow. And that's because on the other side is that motherboard tray that I mentioned, where you can mount fans or radiator to. And then this side is that clear section, which is not as stressful as you might think if you're worried about cable management, because there is this metal insert that hides all of your cables. And so instead, you actually have this opportunity, I think, for showcasing some kind of personalization. Like if you wanted to, you could put stickers or vinyl decals or some other kind of artwork behind it. And basically this forms kind of a picture frame for it. One last thing I want to show you for comparison is the 5000 series versus the 4000 series. So while these are really similar in concept and look, there are a couple of different elements between the two series. So as you can see, the 4000 series is a decent amount smaller than the 5000 series. I also have a Yoshi Amiibo up here for scale, so you can kind of get a sense of how much smaller the 4000 series is. The fronts are the same, essentially. You have the panel with a filter underneath, but the tops are a bit different. So the 4000 series has just this filter on top, magnetic filter, that goes right here, and it's flush up here. Whereas the 5000 series has this plate or this, you know, panel with the filter underneath. So you can remove this and then get at the magnetic filter this way. Like the 4000 series, the 5000 series does have this color branding, so that little tab to help you pull it up. Again, I'm not personally the biggest fan of a difference in color here, just because I prefer a more uniform look when it comes to color schemes, but I know some people do like that kind of, you know, pop splash of color. Speaking of, both the top IO ports here for the USB Type-A does have that Corsair branding. I know some people in the previous 4000 series video thought that it had to do with actual USB specification type things, but no, it's just actual color coding, and that's it. The other main difference between the 5000 series and the 4000 series is this side panel here. So on the 4000 series, this is just a solid side panel, whereas on the 5000 series, you do have this additional airflow section here, and that's because you have that motherboard tray fan bracket behind it. So taking off those side panels, you can see further differences. So 4000 series is, you know, your standard mid-tower, this is the side where all your cables get hidden type arrangement. 5000 series, you have that motherboard tray fan bracket that's specific to the 5000 series, as well as this door, which is on a hinge. And this hides all of your cables. So on the 5000D and 5000D airflow, your cable management is not going to be seen anyway because this part on the side panel is actually solid. However, on the 5000X, this gives you the ability to kind of keep that out of sight if you don't feel like being particularly meticulous with your cable management. All right, moving on to the interior of the case finally. I'm going to do a bit of a tour as I tear this down. I've also switched over to the 5000X case just because we got it in white. It's a little easier for y'all to see what's happening. So first up, I've pulled off this, I guess you'd call it the main tempered glass panel. So this is the side that is tempered glass for all the 5000 series cases. And this comes off real easy. Both side panels do actually. It's the same for both. You just loosen the thumb screws at the back, and then because this is just held in place by tabs and these two resistance pegs, you give it a little bit of a tug and then you just pull it right out. On this side of the case, as you can see, it's a fairly standard layout for a mid-tower case. You've got your power supply shroud here, and that's what's interesting or a little bit more unique about the 5000 series versus the 4000 series is that part of this can be removed. So this section here is held in place by thumb screws. So if you need more clearance for a radiator, then you can just pull that right out. That same modularity applies to the front here where the fans and or radiator would mount. So that's also held in place by thumb screws. You just loosen those, take them out. Makes it a little easier to get everything onto the bracket. And then I guess finishing out to things that are modular is this cable bar here. So if you decide to use the motherboard tray fan bracket to get access to it, you would just take this off and then the bracket is right behind it. Everything else is pretty standard here, as I was saying. So your motherboard tray, you've got 7 PCIe slots here for the normal horizontal orientation, and then you've got an additional 2 here that Corsair has included to support vertical GPU mounting. In case you're wondering, this is fairly close to the glass, so you've got maybe about like 3/4 inch to 1 inch of clearance between where this bracket ends, or sorry, the slot ends, and then where the glass will go. And then at the front here, for the 5000X in particular, it comes, as you can see, with 3 fans pre-mounted. These are 120mm RGB fans. For the 5000D and 5000D airflow models, you'll just get 1 120 at the front and 1 120 at the back, and those are non-RGB. Moving on to the other side, I've again taken off the side panel already. This is flipped around. So just like the other side, it comes off real simple. You just loosen thumb screws, and then because it's held in place by the tabs and these two resistant pegs, then you just give it a little bit of a tug and you just pull it off real easy. For the 5000 series, as I've shown you already, you have this airflow section. So the filter is here on this opposite side, but it's mounted a little bit differently depending on which model you have. So the 5000D models, the way you remove it is that you kind of slide it a little bit and just kind of pull it out from under the lip that's holding it in place. And then for the 5000X, which you see here, this is held in by a series of clips. So taking it out is just a little bit different, but functionally same. You can remove it to wash it down and, you know, clean it up if it gets caked with dust. Underneath that side panel, again, this is the standard layout for the 5000D series. You've got the motherboard tray fan bracket right here, and then you have a panel on a set of hinges, so forming a door that hides all of your cables. Now, on the 5000D and 5000D Airflow, it's not really going to matter if you leave this door on or not, because this part of the side panel is, you know, solid. You're not going to see anything underneath it anyway. But for the 5000X model, which we have here, because it's clear tempered glass, if you want, you can remove that. So if you like having it exposed because you like the look, or you have amazing cable management skills and want to show it off, you have the option to make this all visible. Underneath here, the layout is pretty straightforward. You have cable management channel here for all your cables, and then you have a fan controller, which all the 5000 series cases come with. And then you also have a bracket for storage, so you can put a hard disk drive on here or an SSD. You have the 2.5 inch mounting brackets here, and then you have a removable drive cage at the bottom here. So this is also repositionable, so you can loosen thumb screws, move it around based on how much space you need, or just take it out entirely. For the 5000X model, it comes with a RGB controller pre-installed here on the accessory bracket. This is the most base model. This is the basic model. It is the core controller. If you need to put a hard disk drive on here, you're going to have to figure out a different spot to put it, but otherwise it comes pre-installed like that right there. At the bottom here, there's an accessory that the case comes with, and this is related to the front section of the shroud. So, as I mentioned earlier, that front section of the power supply shroud area is removable, so that if you need more space for a radiator, you can take it. And if you do that, you can use this particular accessory to still hide the end of the shroud. So let's say you take that out and now you have this like gaping hole. Well, you just cover that using this accessory here. Final note for you all, this particular fan tray, you get about an inch and a quarter depth here. Brings it flush with the motherboard tray. So if you want to be flush with the motherboard tray, that's about an inch and a quarter right there. Quick look at what's inside the accessories box. So Corsair includes the standard assortment you'd expect for screws. So, you know, fan mounting, power supply, extra standoffs, etc., etc. And as you can see here, they all come individually bagged, which is a detail that I really like. They even include two things that I'm not expecting, or I wasn't expecting rather, and one of them is this extra door stopper. So this essentially is what you use to keep the swinging door from going too far. And then they also include a right angle USB 3.0 header, which I think is actually kind of nice to have as well. They also include a boatload of Velcro ties. So if you need to keep your cables tidy, that really shouldn't be an issue given how many of these that you get. Okay, so I've torn it all down, or mostly torn it down. I did leave a few things on here just because I didn't want to completely have to pull out all the fans and redo the wires later, being a little bit lazy. So just for, you know, official record here, you can still pull off this bracket and these brackets as well. For the most part, this is really easy to tear down. I actually really liked how fast it was. Some simple things like the dust filters on the bottom and even the front, they come off real smooth. Sometimes bottom filters can get a little sticky when you pull them out, but not this one. The only real build notes I have, if you're going to be working in this case, just kind of tips to keep in mind as you're working with it, is that first off, On the back here, if you decide that you want to use the motherboard fan bracket, so this piece right here, excuse me, I've got upside down, this piece right here, and you need to take out the cable management bar, then you will want to actually remove this first. It's not strictly necessary, but when this is in, the only access you're going to have to the two thumb screws on this particular piece here is by sticking your hand in like this, hand and or screwdriver if you have a shorter screwdriver. So if you can manage it, great, but I found it just simpler to take it all off instead. Speaking of, the screws actually kind of line up like this, so you don't need to take off this cable routing channel to get access to these three points for the screws. It may look that way at first because, you know, when it comes, all the cables are pre-routed, it's a little bit visually noisy, but it's actually not necessary. I've only pulled this off because I did a teardown. The other note that I have is in regards to the power supply shroud, the removable section. So, you know, this is made of plastic, which, you know, makes sense. It makes it a little easier to get in and out because it flexes a little bit. The rest of the shroud is metal. But that does mean that if you are like me and you sometimes break plastic things because you use a little too much force, it's something to keep in mind. You'd be a little more careful. What makes it easiest is if once you've unloosened the thumb screws, you get under there and you just undo the clips already. So don't just pull once you do the thumb screws. Make sure that you get these clips off the lip, and then you can remove this a little bit easier. Sort of similar note for the replacement piece. So, you know, if you do remove this and then you want to put this piece in instead so that it, you know, covers up the end of the power supply shroud, then you're going to want to flip this onto its back. It makes it a little easier to line up this peg with the hole at the bottom of the case and just line everything up so that, you know, this sits and snaps in easily, and then you can do the screw. Fortunately, when it comes time to remove this, this does not have a lot of resistance. So as long as you, again, undo these clips, get it off the lip, undo the screw, this tugs, you give it a little bit tug and it comes out real nice and clean. Moving on to the final section of this video, I'm going to show you all what it looks like to have, you know, various components in here. This is less about showing a build and more about just giving you, you know, space and scale. In a case like this, which is already so large, you really don't have to worry about components fitting, but still, I think that it's nice to get a sense of what it's like to put something in here. So first up is the graphics card. I've got a reference GTX 1080 kind of fake mounted here, and I've put it approximately where, you know, the top slot an ATX board would be. You have a lot of room to work with. Again, this is like 20 and a half inches depth here. And so if you were to put a front mounted radiator in addition to the fans that are here on this 5000X, you're looking about taking about that much space approximately to here. So that means you still have about that much room to work with for length of graphics card. That's more than enough for even the beefiest 1600 XT or 3090. So I really don't think you have anything to worry about. The only thing to consider, again, is just that if you do a vertical GPU mount here, you're really only working with just about half an inch of clearance between where the fan on the card's going to be and where the glass is. So if you're doing a standard air cooling, then you have to take that, you know, amount of airflow into consideration. For the power supply, it shares the space in the shroud here with the hard drive cage. So you'll have to negotiate that space based on obviously the length of your power supply, as well as, you know, if you want the hard drive cage in. So if you do need to move the hard drive cage around, it's really simple. You just loosen the two thumb screws, you give it a little push forward, and it comes straight out if you need to remove it entirely. If you don't, you can move it between one of three positions. So there's this far back position, there's this middle position, and then there's this front position. In a case like this, I'm going to assume that most people are going to be doing slightly above pure budget builds. And so you're likely going to want to be either in the middle or even all the way to the front. In a case like this, because you have so much depth, you're probably going to be fine at the front, even if you do put a radiator and a set of fans at the front. For this example, I'm going to put the drive cage in the middle position, so that way you get a sense of how tight the space is between the power supply and the hard drive cage if you're using a higher wattage PSU. Okay. Our example power supply is this 1000-watt EVGA modular model. Obviously, I don't have the cables attached to it. If you have built with higher wattage power supplies before, you'll have an idea of how much space you're going to really get when you, wad up the excess length on your active cables or active use cables and put it here. If you haven't built with it before, I would say that this is probably just enough space to accommodate any standard cables that come with a power supply. Usually with those, you have a little extra length that you do need to kind of tuck away. If you're using custom cables, like custom length cables, you probably won't have to worry about that as much. If you're somebody who likes to store all of your cables that come with power supply because you're afraid you'll lose some, then you are probably going to want to move that drive cage forward and get a little extra space so you can kind of like squish everything in. All right, so that does it for our look at Corsair's new 5000 series. These cases will be available starting January 14th, and they'll come in two colors, both black and white. You should be able to find these at all major e-tailers, and for us in the US, that will include Newegg. For pricing, you're looking at $150 US for the 5000D and 5000D Airflow, while the 5000X is $190. I will say, regardless of your feelings on the pricing for all of those, if you're interested in these cases, you should probably try to get them as soon as they go live, as soon as they become available, because back in September, the 4000 series sold out really fast, and given that PC components are still hard to get right now, and the human malware situation has not improved, I don't think it's going to be much better this time around. Real quick before we go, on the note of pricing, and I'm sure there's some people who think, wow, this is just a fancier upsized version of the 4000 series and it's a lot more expensive. Why would I ever pay that? Everyone has different needs and I can't speak to what you would need, but I will say that personally, I'm glad to see that Corsair has put this out there. I like that they have a kind of a cleaner version of some of the more gamery, almost aggressive looks that you get from Thermaltake and Fantex while still putting their own spin on it. And if you want to be able to personalize your case and personalize your build, this means you have even one more option to consider. I don't really see that many cases that are doing this like tempered glass side on the right hand side that allows you to, you know, both hide your cables or even show off your cable management and just gives you that flexibility. So I'm all in favor of accessibility and, you know, choices. And if Corsair is listening, I would love to see a 4500X where it's not quite so large because I live in pretty cramped quarters. I know a lot of people don't also need this much space in a case, but I do like that idea of having some customization on that right-hand side. Those are my thoughts, of course. I'd love to hear yours. So if you have any questions, comments, or suggestions, leave them below. Otherwise, I'll catch you next video.